Hello and welcome to my channel. In this video, we will find the step response of a control system. So we have a control system with its transfer function. We apply a step input and we have to find the total response of the system. The total response consists of two parts, the force response and the natural response, and we have to find both of them. Then we will also see how we can obtain the form of a control system response just by looking at the transfer function. So let's get started. So let us say that we have a system denoted by G of S, and we apply an input which is denoted by R of S, and the output of the system is denoted by C of S. And let us say that this input is a step input, so which is represented by 1 divided by S. So this is our step input. So let's start with a transfer function. So the system has a transfer function equal to S plus 2 divided by S plus 5. So this is a simple first order system which has a pole at minus 5 and a 0 at minus 2. So if you plot this on sigma j omega, so 1, 2, there is a 0 here. This is minus 5, so there is a pole here. So now, when we apply this step input, so as you know that the output is the product of the input and the transfer function. So output of the system, CS, so this is called the, also called the response of the system, or the output response of the system. So when we say response, so it means what is C of S, or the output of the system. So we can also find this in T domain, which we will do next, but if we start from the S domain, because the transfer function is always in S domain. So this is the transfer function. So when we apply step input, the output will be S plus 2 S plus 5 multiplied by 1 divided by S, the step input. So this is the output of the system. Now here, this is the polynomial fraction, and in order to go from S domain to T domain, what we do, we use partial fractions. And we decompose this into two smaller fractions. So let's say A divided by S plus B divided by S plus 5. So this is what we have to find, these constants. In order to, as you will see that at the end of this video, you don't have to find this constant. Without finding the constants, you can write down the form of the output response. And this is what we will do. Just by inspection of this transfer function, we will be able to write the response of the system both in S domain or in T domain. So this is what we are going to learn here. But we will start from the mathematics, just to let you know that how we find these constants. And there is a video about the Heaviside method, which we are using here to find this constant, which is also called a cover-up method. So there is a video you can find in the list of the videos. So there will be a video available. So what we do in Heaviside method is, if we have to find A, what is the denominator of A? S. So we put S equal to 0. We find that value and we put that value into this, and we ignore this term, which is the denominator of A. Similarly, in order to find B, we put S plus 5 equals to 0, which will give us S equals to minus 5. We put S minus 5 into this whole, and we ignore the denominator of B, S plus 5. So we put a finger here. This is also called a cover-up method. You just cover this with your finger. So this is what we are going to do. So A is equal to, I write here S plus 2, S plus 5 at S equal to 0, and we are ignoring this thing. So which will give us, if I put S 0 in his, in these two, we get A equal to 2 divided by 5. Similarly for B, we write down S plus 2, ignore this thing, so divided by S, at S equals minus 5. So what we get here, equal to minus 5 plus 2 is minus 3 divided by minus 5, which will make it 3 divided by 5. So this is how we get A and B. Now these are the two constants. So now here I want to show you something, that if you look at the evaluation of these constants, you will see that zero and the pole both are involved in finding these constants. So now I will go forward and I will come back to this point. So now the output response of the system equal to 2 divided by 5 plus 3 divided by 5. And this is in the S domain. Now if you use the Laplace transform table from going to S to T domain, you will find that this term 2 by 5 divided by S is basically in time domain. Now we are going from S domain to time domain. So the output in time domain will be equal to, this is simply 2 divided by 5 and plus this is simply 3 divided by 5 e raised to the power minus 5 t. So this is the inverse Laplace transform of this S domain output of the system. So now we get this. So this is the total response of the system. And this has two components. The first, which is 2 by 5, if you look at S domain, this is S. This is 1 divided by S, which was our input. So the first part of this total response is due to the input function, the step function. And the second part is due to the transfer function or the pole of the system. So this is pole of the system. So there is the part of the response which is due to the input function is called the forced response, because we are trying to get a response. We are trying to input something, and there is part of the response that is dependent on then that input is basically a forced, because we are forcing it. So this is called the forced response, and this is called the natural response, because pole is a characteristic of the system. So the response due to the pole or poles of the system, if there are more than one pole, there will be more terms here. So that is called the natural response, and the response which is due to the input is called the forced response. Let's say in the beginning we have this, and we want to find the response of this transfer function. So as you can see that this zero only affects the constant, because when we were finding the constants, we were putting this in the numerator. So the zero of the system only contributes to the constant. Only the poles contribute to the response of the system, the output of the system, as here. So we can say, just by looking at this, that there will be some constant. Let's say we say K1. In the S domain. So there will be some constant K1 divided by if the input is step plus some constant K2 and divided by S plus 5. So this is how we can, by looking at the transfer function, we can write down this equation, and from this equation we can also write down in time domain, because only this will be in time domain. So C in time domain would be K1 plus K2 e raised to the power minus whatever is the pole, which is 5t. So this is how we can write the response straight away in S domain or in T domain. In both ways we can easily find. So in S we have to write the input function, in time domain we have to only write the constant. So let us do one or two exercises so you can quickly see that how can we quickly find the response of a system just by looking at the transfer function of the system. So you should be able to write down this equation by looking at the transfer function of the system. Let us do some examples. So this is an example. So we have G of S, and again R of S equals step input, and the CFS we have to find out, and the transfer function of the system equal to, let's say, S3, 4 and 5. So First, let us write down in S domain. So we will say the output of the system in S domain would be equal to some constant K1 multiplied by the input. So K1 multiplied by 1 divided by S. So it is simply K1 divided by S plus second constant and the first pole, K2 divided by this one plus K3 divided by S plus 4 plus K4 divided by S plus 5. So this is the response of the system in S domain. But normally when we say the output response of the system, we are talking about in time domain, not in S domain, because in time domain it is easier for us to visualize. So let us write down this in T domain. So CFT would be only K1 here plus K2 e raised to the power minus 3 of T plus K3 e raised to the power minus 4 of T and K4 e raised to the power minus 5 T. So this is the response of the system. Now if you have to find these constants, then you can use the Heaviside method which I described earlier, and you can find these constants. Watch that Heaviside method video and you will be able to find the constant if you have to find the constant. Otherwise, this is just called the form of the response. So this is the total response. Only this part is due to the input. So this is the forced response, and all these terms, they are the natural response of the system, because these terms are due to the characteristic of the system, due to the poles of the system. So therefore this is natural and this is forced. So very simple. So now what if there are more than one zeros? The input is step, but the transfer function has more than one zeros, S plus 2, S plus 3, S plus 4. So even in that situation, because the input is step, so you will get one S here. I have not written the output equation here, because CS would be equal to 1 divided by S into the transfer function. So if, for example, there are more zeros, still you have only the step input is coming here, so you will only get one constant, and all the effect of other zeros will be in calculation of these constants. So that will be the effect of those zeros. Otherwise, the form of the output, this is called the form of the output, will be just like this. One constant due to zeros and all other constants due to poles. So the form of the system response would still be the same, even if there are more zeros. So I hope that after this, you should be able to write down the form of the response of the system and both components, the forced and the natural, just by looking at the transfer function of the system. So I hope you find this video useful. If so, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so you can get the notification whenever I post videos on control systems or on LaTeX or other subjects which I teach. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.